It was bound to happen. So I was about 10, 12 minutes from house. The light came on. As always, I said, that's a false alarm. Who cares? Started feeling a little bit loose. And unfortunately, as I was coming down my street, I was hearing noises, and it was just, I probably need to freaking buy two new tires now, and I'm not gonna just buy them separately. I'm probably just gonna buy the rims, have some spares. The important thing, I didn't see a nail yet. I didn't see a nail yet. I'm gonna take it out. Let's pump it up. Let's have a look. I'm very puzzled by this. I do not see any holes or damage. Very strange, unless it's some weird freak thing inside, I don't know. But as you can see, I haven't seen anything shiny. I don't even see a hole that might have fallen out. Super weird anyway. Swing it around to the side here. Let's look at this front section. One sec. A scratch? No, I mean, I did, of course. I mean, I put a freaking scratch in that thing. My fault. Let's see. Nothing. What about sidewalls? Any rips? Any cuts? No? Man. How weird. There's no way it's the... Oh! What? Do you think it's the freaking stem? That stem looks fucking bent, dude. Holy shit. Holy shit. Let me see. All right. Enough talking. Let me get this. I want to see. Maybe I can get a tire shop quick to get a stem. I doubt it. I can probably just work on a, you know, I have other wheels I can use. Let me get this going. Have you ever seen anything like that? Wow. I mean, how would that even... Something had to touch it, right? A rock? That is a bummer, but I'm also... It's also a good thing. This all comes down to whether or not I drove too long and messed up the inside of the tire or not. I probably need to replace this anyway because it looks like total crap. But, I mean, to get me around for a while, I wouldn't be too upset with that. Bummer. Results. Not good. Not good. Yeah. This tire is not going to be run again. It is completely destroyed. Disappointing, of course. Damn. So what am I going to do, you ask? First off, this is why you don't sell your old parts when you put on your aftermarket parts. I have four perfectly good wheels sitting in the shed. Now, I'm not going to waste my time changing all four for now. I am going to change two to get the treads pretty balanced. And then as soon as I get inside, I'm ordering two more of these ready to go from Tire Rack. Two, I need matching tread. I need matching tread. These are all like a good 25% used, at least, probably a third used. I'm not going to mismatch the treads like that. So yeah, it sucks. $500-$600, unexpected. But this whole saving grace, I have wheels to use until it comes in. That's the most insane part. I'm not even super sad because I don't have to worry about work, getting to work or whatever. So I'm just going to go put, oh man, it's going to look so bad. Oh my God. I guess I'll put, I don't want to touch the rear, so it's going to look even worse. I'm going to put the crappy rims in the front and leave those on the rear. Whatever. My business, nobody else's. They'll think I'm crazy. They'll think that's my style. Super bummer. All this good fortune was too good to last. Something had to happen. So let me get these tires swapped out. Whew. Diverted for now. This is pretty cringeworthy. Really sad. I mean, I don't hate these rims, but mix and match is just disgusting. It's ugly. That already looks way better. God damn it. All right, they're torqued. This weekend I'll have a wheel install video, unless they're out of stock, and then I may not. All I can say is blessed nothing else happened to the car. No suspension damage, nothing. If I'd known it was that flat, I would have stopped, but I just wasn't feeling any drifting or anything. It's really weird how the car continues to go straight, even with like a completely flat tire. I don't get it. Maybe my alignment's really good. All right, guys. Well, I gotta freaking relax. I've been working on this for an hour and a half after a freaking 9-hour day. I need to freaking rest.